Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hello smart students. Anyway, today is review time. Hari ini kita hanya mereview materi yang sudah kita pelajari di bab 4 ya. Because next week you do in this exam. Pekan depan sudah waktunya untuk ujian bahasa Inggris. Well, let's pray before studying. In the first meeting we learned about text reading with the title Thank You Allah on page 56. Let's review. Ya dulu ya. Thank you Allah. Artinya terima kasih Allah. Nah, sekarang ayo kita simak bersama penjelasan dari setiap kalimatnya. Rosanna likes her school bag. Rosanna suka tas sekolahnya. She got it from her parents. She got it from her parents. Dia mendapatkannya dari orang tuanya. They bought it for her. They bought it for her. Mereka membelinya untuk dia. She always takes care of it every day she goes to school. Dia selalu mengurusnya setiap hari saat dia pergi ke sekolah. She always says, "Thank you Allah for giving me this nice school bag." Dia selalu mengatakan, "Terima kasih Allah telah memberikan saya tas sekolah yang bagus ini." Okay, for the next meeting, we learn about words, sounds, SH, CH, and TH. On page 57, let's review.
Words have the letters CH. Chin. Chin. Chill. Chill. Very good. These next words have the letters C and H at the end. Much. Much. Ch-ch. Teach. Teach. Ch-ch. Words have the letters S-H. Sheet. Sheet. Shut. Shut. Shape. Shape. Very good. These next words have the letters SH at the end. Brush. Brush. Sh, sh. Cash. Cash. Sh, sh. Wish. Wish. Words, the letters TH make a soft sound. Thin. Thin. Thud. Thud. Third. Third. Thaw. Thaw. Thirst. Thirst. Thank. Thank. Very good. In these next words, the letters TH make a soft sound at the end. Cloth. Cloth. path. Path. Both. Both. Fourth. Fourth. Fifth. Fifth.
Okay, next, we have learned about possessive nouns. It's on page 60. Let's review.
Dalam bahasa Indonesia, possessive noun adalah kata benda yang menunjukkan kepemilikan ataupun kepunyaan. Apa sih yang dimaksud dengan kata benda yang menunjukkan kepemilikan? Ayo disimak videonya. Ustazah kasih contoh ya. Ini adalah kucingnya Fatima. Katanya di sini menunjukkan kepemilikan. Jika dalam bahasa Inggris, kalimatnya "This is Fatima's cat." Nah, tanda koma atas inilah yang merupakan possessive noun. Jadi diingat ya, possessive noun menggunakan apostrof S atau tanda koma atas ditambah huruf S setelah pemiliknya. Bagaimana nih? Sudah paham? Ustazah kasih contoh satu lagi ya. Ayo diperhatikan contoh kedua nak. Kalimatnya yaitu, ini adalah payungnya Rian. Ayo, ada yang tahu bagaimana bahasa Inggris dari kalimat tersebut? Iya betul, this is Rian's umbrella. Rian's umbrella. Ingat ya, apostrof S setelah kata pemiliknya.
The last, we learned about say bismillah and alhamdulillah. Let's review.
Before we go to bed, what do we say? Bismillah. And when we are awake, what do we say? Alhamdulillah. Before we eat our food, what do we say? Bismillah. And whenever we're done, what do we say?
Bismillah, alhamdulillah.
have reviewed all the lesson on chapter 4. Now, let's complete your daily score.
Nah, sekarang bagi yang masih belum lengkap tugas hariannya, silahkan dikerjakan ya, Nak.
Jangan lupa dokumentasi saat menyimak video ini ya. Thank you. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.